Hey guys, Coach Dorsett asked me to make a video for you about what advice I would give my middle school self. Frankly, I was a brat in middle school, so I probably wouldn't have listened to me, but here it is. The first thing I would tell myself is always be kind, or laugh at farts, and hear me out, you'll hear why. Kindness is a choice. Jonathan Carroll once said, "I firmly believe in small gestures. Pay for their coffee, hold the door for strangers, over tip, smile or try to be kind even when you don't feel like it. Pay compliments, chase the kid's runaway ball down the sidewalk and throw it back to him. Try to be larger than you are, particularly when it's difficult. People do notice, people appreciate. I appreciate when it's done for me. Small gestures can be an effort. They actually go against our grain. People say all the time, I'm not one big or big for playing compliments. But the irony is that almost every time you make them, you feel better about yourself. For a moment, life suddenly feels lighter, a bit more like Gene Kelly dancing in the rain. Also, in that, I come from a culture where if you admire something and you don't do something about it, you can give it the evil eye. So if you're looking at someone's ice cream because you want some and it falls on the floor, that kind of thing. I'm not superstitious, but I do take that to the heart in the sense of what good does it do for me not to voice that? If someone's has cool socks, tell them, why not? It probably just made their day, and you need to do it right then. Every good thought that comes in your head, voice it. And if the opportunity passes you by, remember you can always go back and say it to them later. A friend that helped you earlier that day, but you were so caught up and you didn't say anything, send them a text while you're thinking about it, telling them thank you. There'll always be times where you want to curse someone's breed, creed, and country, but it does you no good. You still have to actively make the choice to be kind. A friend once told me, "I don't understand people who don't laugh at farts. They're still going to have just as many farts in their life, but fewer laughs. Why would you choose that life?" Being kind is kind of like laughing at farts. The other part I would tell myself is you don't have to date. If it seems like everyone else is dating, just remember that middle school relationships are not the one. I am sure they really mean a lot to each other right now, but as you grow as human beings, you aren't going to be the same person as you are right now. Think about it. If your mom liked the same stuff that you do, down to the crush on the latest teen hottie, it'd be weird. So with that in mind, you grow old, you change, the person changes. Maybe you won't change in ways that compliment anymore. Or maybe you'll get to know them and you realize you're not about that life. I only know of two couples in my whole life who have married people they even knew in middle school, much less dated. So don't stress about it. And if you are dating, just remember that what you think is heartbreak now is nothing compared to what it'll be in later in life. So don't sweat it just yet. Spend these years growing and having fun. Emery Allen says there's so much more to life than finding someone who will want you or being sad over someone who doesn't. There's a lot of wonderful time to be spent discovering yourself without hoping someone will fall in love with you along the way. And it doesn't need to be painful or empty. You need to fill yourself up with love, not anyone else. Become a whole being on your own. Go on adventures. Fall asleep in the woods with friends. Sit in a coffee shop on your own. Write on bathroom stalls, not in the classroom. Don't do that. Leave notes in the library. Dress up for yourself. Give to others. Smile a lot. Do all things with love, but don't romanticize yourself or romanticize life like you can't survive without it. Live for yourself and be happy on your own. It isn't any less of a beautiful place, I promise. And I'd tell myself, do what you like. So, as much as we like to talk trash about you guys obsessing over dumb stuff, embrace the awkward years. It's time to start figuring out who you are, so don't shy away from what you really like. Read a book you like if you like reading, or play basketball if you want to try it out. Don't let your peers keep you from trying new things, and if someone should put you down for it, keep on keeping on. Practice the very polite way of blowing people off, of thank you for the advice, I will take that into consideration. Assuming it's healthy. If a friend is staging an intervention because you thoroughly enjoy kicking puppies, you deserve every name that they call you. Otherwise, find what you like and surround yourself with it. Remember, the sun isn't bright just because we say it's bright. It just is. It was bright even before it knew the word bright. We didn't decide what it is. We acknowledged what it is. You aren't worth something just because we say you are. You just are. You're worth something before we even said anything. We didn't decide that you are. We acknowledged that you are. That's what we mean when we say you're worth it. All right, I got two more things that I'd tell myself. I would tell myself, love your body as it is. Be healthy. smile. Even if you do have a mouthful of metal, you'll regret having no smiley pictures when you're older. Even though you get annoyed when mom yells at you to smile and that closed mouth smirk doesn't count, she's right. Embrace that train track smile. Even if you aren't as toned as you want to be and your body doesn't look like you want it to, it's the only body you got and you have to take care of it. I look back on the amount of time I spent hating my body, and I wasn't always nice to it, and I did things that weren't good or healthy for it, and I formed this habit of not liking my outside that it's now so hard to break. And middle school bodies are the time that things are going to start to change. Puberty is going to hit you like a truck. I had a friend that always told me that he knew people that fell out of the puberty tree and hit every branch on the way down. So chances are you'll find something you're insecure about. And remember that it's just part of change. If you're gaining weight, it's because you're growing. Your acne is a sign of getting older and wiser. Everyone experiences puberty differently at different times, which means comparing yourself to others is not fair. Hang in there. You'll get through the awkward phase and your hormones will balance out. And in the meantime, be healthy. Because really, this is the only body you have. And the last thing I'd tell myself is find your group. Even if that group doesn't stay the same from one day to the next, humans are built as social creatures. You need a community that you can talk to and feel comfortable around. And it doesn't have to be a big crowd, and it probably won't be. It's okay to be popular and friendly with people, but you don't need close friends you can trust. They'll never agree with you on everything you say or do, but that's okay too. They'll love you for you, and you'll feel comfortable enough to be honest. And they'll feel comfortable enough to be honest. And you'll be comfortable enough to take their advice with a grain of salt, so to speak. There's a difference between helpful advice and criticism that holds you back. So be careful who you listen to. Some people want you to succeed, others don't. Develop a strong filter for whose words you take to heart and whose words you ignore. Some questions to ask yourself. Do I trust this person? Are they respectable? Do they practice what they preach? Are they a kind person? Are they the kind of person that I hope I can become? Do they recognize my talent and potential and encourage me, or do they drag me down by harping on where I fall short? How others talk to you influences how you talk to yourself. And since that voice in your head impacts your confidence, determination, and willingness to take risks, you want people in your life who speak the truth in love and always with the best intent in mind. This includes adults. Some of them do have some insight. Now, I don't think middle school me would listen to any of this, but that's what I would tell myself, and hopefully I would take it to heart.